from China, you open a very small market. But it's a very mature market, and it's a market where we are selling a lot of high-end models. So it's a very good test for the Chinese industry to come and to put the product on the European market to check that we are competitive. That's why Haier asked me to develop what we call the premium strategy, means that we move from entry model to more premium high-end model. What we need to do is that we need to understand the local market. So I have here R&D center for Europe, dedicated to Europe, to develop the product linked to the European needs. And of course, after we need the factory need to be flexible enough to produce for us and to adapt what are the European needs on what we call the platform. For us, a very, very big asset to be a worldwide company. Yes. The Chinese way of working is different. There's a lot of difference in the culture. Example, regarding the reporting. So in Europe, normally executive like me make a monthly report, quarterly report. In China, executive like me are making weekly report. And for the normal staff, the employees, they need to report every day to the boss, which is for us totally incredible. In Europe, we have a fixed salary, but in China, there's no fixed salary. They can reduce even the fixed salary if something is wrong, if business is bad. So it's totally different mindset that they have compared with Europe. So we need to adapt. They need to adapt to us, but we need to, as well to understand what they are doing. So we have a very strong customer platform with the social media, internet. We collect a lot of customer needs, customer requests, and immediately we communicate with R&D, which is local or in China, to change the product and to adapt to the customer request. So we are very, very reactive. We can change the product in 3 months, which is totally amazing.